This is CN2 Sports. Thanks to a bond referendum in Lancaster County, changes are noticeable now at one high school. And CN2's James Lambert's taking a visit to Lancaster High School to see those changes in tonight's Campus Insider.
Thanks, guys. I'm here at Lancaster High School. Joining with me is Mark Strickland, athletic director. Coach, thanks for inviting me.
Well, you're welcome. Glad to have you here.
Thank you. First of all, I just want to say, how long have you been athletic director here at Lancaster?
I've been the athletic director here now going on 11 years, but I've been at Lancaster High School for 32 years.
Wow. So how would you basically give a quick summary of all things Lancaster athletics this past season?
Well, we had a very successful season or school year, and I believe it was all but two of our teams made the playoffs. So we're real proud of the boys and girls that were on those teams. We had a region champion in softball, boys tennis, which is a big accomplishment for us. But historically, our softball program has been very good. And we had football made it into the playoffs. So we had a real successful season.
Talk about the accomplishment of actually having, basically on this athletic program's resume, you guys have now an NBA player in the league.
Yeah, Sundarius. I've known Sundarius since he was a young man, a quality person, and it's pretty evident he's a great athlete, great basketball player. And the town has really embraced that, and it's helped us out. It's brought some positive response from other areas, and I think a lot of our kids, they see that if there's a goal out there and you can go get it, not that anything's guaranteed, and let's face it, the chances of someone making an NBA or a Major League Baseball or professional football is very slim, but we're real proud of what Sundarius has done and how he's represented Lancaster and the University of South Carolina.
There's obviously a lot of construction going on here on campus. How is that affecting your program?
Well, we've had to move our entrances around, which you probably found out today trying to get in here. But there's been a major with the bond referendum. There's been some construction to our school. If you've ever been to Lancaster High School, it's almost like the front of the school is where the back of the school should be when it was first constructed. But they're now changing that. The entrance is going to be out on Woodland Drive now, which is going to be very positive for us. They're building a new multi-purpose gym, which will it's going to be pretty big. We'll be able to hold some other events in there. The community will be able to use it. It will have a capacity for 400 bleacher seats, which is great, but there again, we can have plays and stuff like that in it. So it's going to be a major plus for us. On top of that, they are doing a artificial turf on our football stadium, as they are all the schools in the district other than Indianland, who is going to have a new school. So they're going to wait and put a artificial turf field in there. And then we have up at our track facility, up what we call the Rice area, is where our football and track practice. They're redoing that whole track. They're taking it up completely. My understanding is it's over $1 million project. So we're going to have a track that's going to be second to none. And they're redoing the athletic field, our practice football field, which brings me to this. We've had to move all of our football practices over towards the stadium. There's a field over there that we're using right now. So it's been a big adjustment for the administration, for the athletes, and for the coaches.
Coach, I want to thank you for inviting me, and back to you guys at the studio.
All right, James, thanks so much. And sign-ups underway for after-school programs in Rock Hill. The programs are operated by the Rock Hill Parks, Rec, and Tourism Department. It's for children in kindergarten through the fifth grade. The after-school activities will take place at the Discovery Station there at the Emmett Scott Center as well. The programs offer homework help, literacy development, character education, outdoor rec, all kinds of good stuff.